historiography engineering. As we can see that there are 2 points in this chapter, that is 2.1, tradition of Indian historiography, and 2.2, Indian historiography, various ideological frameworks. From these 2 points, today we are going to just learn the first point of this chapter, that is tradition of Indian historiography. Now first, we will see what is meant by a tradition. Tradition means a custom or a belief or a way of doing something that has continued from the past till the present, means which is going on from the old times. These are the traditions. We have learned about the Western tradition of historiography. We have already learned the Western tradition of historiography in the last lesson, means in the first chapter. In this lesson, we will know about the tradition of Indian historiography. In the last chapter, we have learned about the Western. Now we will see the Indian tradition of Indian historiography. Historiography in the ancient period. Now we will see how was the historiography in the ancient period. In the ancient period in India, memories of the great deeds. Great deeds means great works of ancestors. Great works done by our ancestors. And mythological lore means very old stories. Also, memories of social transitions were preserved with the help of oral recitals. They were preserved in the form of oral ways. There are some methods of preserving history. But in the ancient period, they were preserved in with the help of oral recitals. Recitals means public performance of music or story. The inscriptions on the Harappan seals and other artifacts confirm that Indians had mastered the art of writing as early as the 3rd millennium BCE. Till the 3rd millennium BCE, millennium means a period of 1,000 years. The Indians have mastered the art of writing. Or perhaps before that. However, the Harappan script is not yet successfully deciphered. Do we have mastered the art of writing in the early 3rd millennium BCE? But still now we are not able to decipher it. Decipher means we are not able to read and understand it. It is not clear for us till now. The earliest known written documents of historical nature found in India are in the form of inscriptions. The earliest known written documents of historical nature which are found in India are in the form of inscriptions. Inscriptions means they are inscribed on the hard surfaces. They are dated to the 3rd century BCE. They are also dated to the 3rd century BCE. That is Emperor Ashoka Maurya's times, at the time of Emperor Ashoka's reign. His edicts are inscribed on natural rocks and stone pillars. His edicts have been inscribed. They are inscribed on the natural rocks or on the stone pillars. From the 1st century CE, inscriptions begin to occur on coins, metal images, and sculptures and also on copperplates, means whichever where the hard surface is. Like some examples are given here, like coins, metal images, and sculptures, and also on copperplates. They started to inscribe on it from the first century CE. They provide important historical information. By these inscriptions, we get the important historical information of that specific period by deciphering the inscription. We get to know about the dates of various kings, dynastic genealogies, territorial extent, and administration of various empires and kingdoms. What we get to know? We get to know about the dates of various kings, or dynastic genealogy, means study of the family history, including who the ancestors of a person were, means total history or the background of that family or dynasty. We get to know from these inscriptions, and also the territorial extent of that kingdom or the empire. And administration of various empires and kingdoms. How was the administration being run at that period, at the time of the specific ruler's reign? All this information we get from these inscriptions which we have got. And also important political events like the coronation of any of the king. This is an important event in the history. Next is social organization. Means any specific social organization is being running, or the next is climate famine, etc. of the respective times, of this specific time. We get to know about all the information which is related to the dates of the various kings, dynastic genealogies, or the extent, territorial extent of the empire, administration of the empire, political events, social organization, climate, famine means lack of food for a specific period or a long period is known as a famine. So all these information we get from these inscriptions, and they are the important sources of history. The ancient Indian literature, including the epics Ramayana and Mahabharata, Purans, Jain and Buddhist texts, historical accounts by Indian authors, and also travels of foreign travelers are important sources of history. These are the important sources of history. All the travelers means about the travel. If any traveler is there, he has wrote what he has saw in his travel at the time of traveling is known as travelers. So these all ancient Indian literatures are the important sources of history. By these literatures, we come to know about our history. Writing of biographies of kings and dynastic histories mark an important step in the Indian historiography. In the Indian historiography, the writing of biographies of any of the kings or dynastic histories are the important one in the as a source of history. Harshacharita, written in the 7th century CE. It was written in the 7th century CE by Banabhatta. It was written by Banabhatta is King Harsha's biography. It is related to the King Harsha, King Harshavardhana. This biography is totally related to King Harshavardhana. It portrays a realistic picture of the social, economic, political, religious, and cultural life during the king's time. What is given in this biography in the Harshacharit? Banabhatta has written the realistic, what was the real condition at that time? How was the social, economic, political, religious, and cultural life during the king's time? Then you can see, you would like to know, this is given on page number 7. What is this? You can see, Soha Gaura copper plate. The copper plate was found at Soha Gaura district, Gorakhpur, Uttar Pradesh. It was found at district Gorakhpur, Uttar Pradesh, at Soha Gaura. It is supposed to be from the Mauryan period. It is supposed that this is from the Mauryan period. The inscription on it is in Brahmi script. The inscription, the script was being used to inscribe this text is a Brahmi script. The symbols known as tree in railings and mountain at the beginning of the inscription occur on punch mark coins. These tree in railings and the mountains are also occurred on the punch mark coins, coins of that period. Another symbol, which looks like a structure erected on four pillars, is supposed to be indicative of a granary. We can see here a railing, a tree is there, mountain is there, tree, mountains, and a structure on the four pillars. Here also it is there. So this is given on the copper plate at Soha Gaura. And this, a structure on the, which is erected on the four pillars, is supposed to be indicative of a granary. It is showing like a granary. Granary means where the grains were being stored at that time. The inscription records the royal order. You can see the inscription here. It is the royal order that the grains stored in the granary should be distributed carefully. The grains which are being stored in the granary, that should be distributed carefully. It is supposed to be suggestive of precautions taken in the times of famine. What it is suggestive that we should take the precautions in the time of famine. We need the grains or the food that is being stored in this granary. So we should distribute it very carefully to the public. Then we will move towards the next point of the chapter, that is historiography in the medieval period. In the medieval period, the style of writing Rajatarangini, the style of writing Rajatarangini, the history of Kashmir, that is showing the history of Kashmir in the 12th century CE. the Raj Tarangini, the writing Raj Tarangini is showing the history of Kashmir in the 12th century CE and is written by Kalhana. Who has written this? Kalhana has written this one. It's quite close to the concept of modern historiography. It is closely related to the concept of modern historiography. We have saw the four main characteristics of modern historiography in the first chapter. So these concepts which are being given or written in Raja Tarangini are related to the modern historiography. Kalhana himself says that he wrote this text after critically examining various sources like inscriptions, coins, remains of ancient monuments, dynastic records, and local traditions. Kalhana himself says that when he have written all these things, after critically examining the source of history is the characteristics of the modern historiography. In the modern historiography, it was being used. So the same thing is done by Kalhana in the 12th century CE. Before the writing of modern historiography, he himself says that he wrote this text after critically examining various sources. He critically examined the various sources such as inscriptions, coins, remains of ancient monuments, dynastic records, and the local traditions which were being going on at that time. In the medieval India, the historians in the courts of Muslim rulers were influenced by Arabic and Persian historiography. In the medieval India, the historians in the court of Muslim rulers, whoever the Muslim rulers at that time in their court, some of the writers were there and they were influenced by the Arabic and Persian historiography. Among them, Ziauddin Barani holds an important place. Among these writers, Muslim writers who were there in the court of Muslim rulers, among them were the Ziauddin Barani holds an important place. In Tariq-i-Firuzshahi, a book written by him. He has written a book known as Tariq-i-Firuzshahi. He has stated the purpose of historiography. In his book, he has written that what is the purpose, why he has written this historiography. According to him, the historian's duty is not limited only to the recording of the ruler's values and policies of welfare. According to him, what he says that the duty of historian is not to just write about the good deeds of the ruler or the policies of welfare of the rulers, but also write about the ruler's failings and incorrect policies. If he has lost in the battle, if he has taken any decision and that goes wrong, that also should be written in historiography. Also, the incorrect policies which were being implemented by the ruler. Barani further says that a historian should also take into consideration the impact of the teachings of the wise. What he said that historians should also take into consideration the impact of the teachings of the wise. teaching of the wise means those who are having knowledge or the experience, the learns and the sense on the cultural life of people. Thus, Barani expanded the scope of historiography by including these points in historiography, like the failings or the incorrect policies, or we should take some points or consider the things which were given by the wise people or the learned ones or the saints. So by this, it has expanded, the scope of historiography has been expanded, new points, they got the new points for writing the historiography. So he holds the important place in the medieval period writings. For the historians in the Mughal courts, praising the emperors and exhibition of loyalty became more important. For the historians, whoever in the court of Mughal rulers or the Mughal emperors, they have to praise the emperors. They have to impress the emperors or exhibit. For what purpose? To show that we are loyal to you. That we are loyal to you was becoming more important at that period. The custom of adding suitable poetic and beautiful pictures was also introduced. So to show this thing that we are loyal to the emperor, what they started to do, they started to add the suitable poetic quotes and beautiful pictures. These two things also got introduced in this medieval period. Babur, the founder of the Mughal Empire, wrote an autobiography. Babur, who was the founder of the Mughal Empire, he wrote an autobiography entitled Tujuk-i-Baburi. Autobiography means written by he himself. Entitled Tujuk-i-Baburi. It contains the descriptions of the battles fought by him. What it contains? It contains the descriptions of the battles which were fought by Babur. Babur also recorded his minute observations of various regions and cities traveled by him, including the local economy, customs, and the flora. What he included in his autobiography? The minute observation of the records which he has kept at the time of traveling to various regions of the cities. And also he has included the local economy, how were the customs of that place, and how was the flora. Flora means the plant life of that specific place. Abul Fazl's Akbarnama is very important from the viewpoint of critical historiography. Akbarnama, which was written in the praise of Emperor Akbar. It was written by whom? Abul Fazl. It was written by Abul Fazl. Method of collecting authentic historical documents and their scrutiny is looked upon as devoid of this and hence realistic. What he used to do? He used to collect the authentic historical documents, and after collecting these historical documents, he used to scrutinize it, means do its observation carefully, find whether the document is true or fake. And this is looked upon as void. It's not having any kind of, it is not having any kind of quality, or it is not true. Then you should not take this document into consideration while writing a writing the studio graph. And hence a real used to believe only on the realistic documents or the authentic documents for writing the history. Bakar is an important type of historical documents of medieval times. Another important type of historical document of medieval times is Bakar. We have saw about the autobiography, biography, and next here it is Bakar. Bakar is an important type of historical documents of medieval times. It contains eulogies. Eulogies means what? Writing that says good things about somebody. Writing that says good things about somebody. So now it is given that it contains eulogies of the heroes at that time, and stories of historic events, battles, lives of great men is being written in this historical document known as Bakar. Marathi Bakars are of various types. There are different types of Marathi Bakars. Few examples are given here, like Sabhasad Bakar was written by Krishnaji Anand Sabhasad. It was written by Krishnaji Anand Sabhasad during the reign of Chhatrapati Rajaram Maharaj. The Sabhasad Bakar written by Krishnaji Anand Sabhasad during the reign of Chhatrapati Rajaram Maharaj. It is an important Bakar for getting information. Important Bakar for getting the information about whom, but about the rule of Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj. This Sabhasad Bakar has the writings or the information which is related to the rule of Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj. Bhau Saibhanji Bakar. The name of the Bakar is Bhau Saibhanji Bakar. Describes the Battle of Panipat. In this Bakar, the Battle of Panipat has been described. Another Bakar entitled Panipatji Bakar is also about the same event. Two Bakars like Bhau Saibhanji Bakar and Panipatji Bakar. These are the two Bakars which are being written on the same event. Provides information about the workers and their contributions. It provides the information about the workers and what were their contributions to the Maratha rule. Expand various types. Can be divided into means such as history, description of events, history of the sect, specific group of people who have a particular set of religious beliefs is known as a sect. Autobiographies regarding grievance means something that you think is unfair and you want to complain about that. and state administration by a king. In such a way, we can divide the chapters. Yes, Zain Ansari, if you are having any doubt, I will clear after finishing our period. But do you know even page number 8? What it is given in this, do you know that? Al-Biruni wrote in Arabic about Indian knowledge and social life. Indian knowledge and social life. In the following period, many books about India were written by foreign scholars. Many of the books about India were written by the foreign scholars. Among them, name a few are few names of the book here, like Hasan Nizami's Tajul Ma Asir, Minaj Siraj, Tabakat I Nasiri. Various works by Amir Khusro, Juzuk I Taimuri, the autobiography of Taimur I Lang, who was also known as Amir Taimur, who invaded India. The next is Tariq I Mubarak Shahi by Yahya bin Ahmad Sarhindi. Their accounts provide us with historic information about Sultanate period. Their accounts provide us the historical information about the Sultanate period. Accounts of foreign travelers in India are also important. Among them are Ibn Battuta, Abdul Razak, Marco Polo, Niccolo Conti, Barbosa and Domingo Spies. Their accounts provide us with historic information of medieval India. Their accounts provide us the historic information which is related to the medieval India. Ishwar Das Nagar, Bhimsen Saxena, Khafi Khan and Niccolo Manucci were among the historians of Aurangzeb's times whose accounts are important sources of Mughal history. Their accounts are of the Mughal history. Next. Next point is historiography in the modern period. In the 20th century, yes, Radha, are you having any doubt? Unmute yourself.
No, sir. नो सर गलती से हो गया
ओके पुट योर हैंड डाउन हिस्टोरियोग्राफी इन द मॉडर्न पीरियड इन द 20th सेंचुरी द इंडियन आर्कियोलॉजिकल एक्सप्लोरेशन एंड रिसर्च स्टार्टेड अंडर द ब्रिटिश रूल इन द 20th सेंचुरी द इंडियन आर्कियोलॉजिकल एक्सप्लोरेशन एंड रिसर्च इट वाज started under the British rule. A number of ancient sites were excavated under the supervision of Sir Alexander Cunningham. Many of the sites were being excavated. Under the supervision of Sir Alexander Cunningham, the first Director General of the Archaeological Survey of India. They were the first Director General of the Archaeological Survey of India. statues mainly the sites mentioned in the Buddhist text for this purpose? For the purpose of excavation, he chose the sites which were being mentioned in the Buddhist text. Harappan civilization was discovered during the tenure of Sir John Marshall. At the time, or the during the work period of Sir John Marshall, we have discovered the Harappan civilization. Because of this discovery, the antiquity of Indian history could be traced to 3rd millennium BC or even earlier. Because of this antiquity, discovery of all these old buildings or the objects, we will come to know that history of our country was traced back to 3rd millennium BC or even earlier. We can see the picture of Alexander Cunningham and John Marshall. Many British officials in India wrote about Indian history. Many of the British officials in India, they wrote about the Indian history. Their writings display strong influence of the colonial policies of the British. The writings, they used to display the influence of the colonial policies of the British. Three volumes of the history of British India written by James Mill. There are the three volumes written by James Mill, and which were published in 1817. Its name was The History of British India. This was the first book on Indian history. This was the first book on Indian history written by a British historian. It was written by a British historian. What he did at this time? He divided the history, Indian history, into three periods: the Hindus, the Muslim, and the British. Like this, he divided the Indian history. This was the first book on Indian history written by a British historian. It clearly reflects an absence of objective perspective and prejudice about various aspects of the Indian culture. As I just said, that what he did, he divided the Indian history into three periods: the Hindus, the Muslim, and the British. It shows that prejudice. Without knowing anything about any of our country, or not knowing about our country, he wrote or divided our history into such three periods. Prejudice about various aspects of the Indian culture. The history of India, written by Mount Stuart Elphinstone. The history of India, which was written by Mount Stuart Elphinstone, governor of Bombay, now Mumbai, was published in 1841. The period of Maratha Empire is very important in the Indian history. In the Indian history, the period of the Maratha Empire is very much important for us. Grant Duff's name stands out among the British officers who wrote about Maratha history. The person or the officer, British officer, who wrote about the Maratha history was Grant Duff. He wrote the book entitled A History of the Marathas. He wrote the book and entitled him as The History of Marathas. This book is published in three volumes. This book is also being published in three volumes. Grant Duff's writing also shows the British inclination of condemning Indian culture and history. What it shows that? They used to behave like the way that they are not liking the Indian culture. They used to say that our culture is the best culture in the society and Indian culture is the worst one. This was their saying. And they have written this in their books also. Similar tendency is witnessed in Colonel Todd's writing about Rajasthan's history at the time of Rajasthan's history. Colonel Todd's also done the same thing like Grand Duff. He also showed the British inclination. They started to condemn the Indian culture, means neglect the Indian culture and traditions or the Indian history. The two volumes written by William Wilson Hunter on Indian history show a somewhat impartial treatment of this, of the subject. The two volumes which were written by William Wilson Hunter on the Indian history shows a somewhat impartial, means not supporting one person or a group or the another ones, treatment of the subject. Means he did not supported the two writers like Colonel Todd and the Grand Duff. He wrote his in his way. Neelkanth Janardhan Kirtane and Vishwanath Kashinath Rajwade were two Indian historians. These were the two Indian historians named as Neelkanth Janardhan Kirtane and Vishwanath Kashinath Rajwade. They took upon the task of exposing the limitations of Grand Duff's writing. They took a task that we will expose him, we will show him that Indian culture is at which place, as it was written by Grand Duff. He has written negativity about the Indian culture. So they took upon the task of exposing the Grand Duff. So the point is over. Today's topic points are over. We will have evaluation. Like we can see, look at the picture and fill in the blanks. Blanks are being given here. You have to look at the picture, which picture it is, and you have to answer the given questions or fill in the blanks. The copper plate was found at dash. Where this copper plate was found? Yes, Aditya, unmute yourself. Aditya, unmute yourself. Okay, Mahika.
Hello, good morning, sir.
Good morning. You the answer.
Sir, Gorakhpur, Uttar Pradesh.
Okay, just fill in the blank. You have to just write the name of the place. Not district and the thing.
Okay, sir. Bye-bye.
Okay. Mahika. Give the answer.
Soha
Gora is the answer. Very good.
Sir.
It is supposed to be from the dash period.
Yes, society supposed to be from?
Mauryan period.
Mauryan period. It is supposed to be from the Mauryan period. Next one. The inscription on it is in the script.
Sir, can I say?
Brahmin script.
Brahmini script.
It is in a Brahmi script. Very good, students. This is your homework. Note down all of you. The homework is read the chapter and find the difficult words, meanings. Many difficult words are given in this chapter. So you have to read the full chapter, find the difficult words, meanings.